I'm here in the AMD booth with Gilles, who's here to tell me a little bit about how AMD is involved with networking. First and foremost, 6G. We're just finishing up rolling out 5G. Is 6G official? Is it announced? Or
so, as a technology provider, we always need to be 5 years ahead of the market. So 6G will probably starting deploying by 2029, 2030, but we need to start working now because our customers, the wireless and vendors, are already starting to look at what they will do with it. And so what we want to show them is that we have already the technology today that will allow them to do all their POC early ramp up and deployment with the 6G when they will need it.
Okay.
So that's why we are showing that today.
Yeah, because right now 5G is already kind of a cutting edge.
Yep. Yep.
What are you doing so that 6G will have even more advantage? Like what's the new technology here?
So 6G will be AI based, that we call AI native. Two value proposition for 6G. One is all the network management that will be much more efficient, managing better spectrum, managing the power, managing the efficiency of the radios, managing the user mobility, having a better user experience. Everything will be AI driven. So that's one. Two, we'll have a higher capacity.
Or one of the issues with mobile networks and telecommunications in general is latency. Like if you're on a phone, it's a little bit slower than if you're plugging into a laptop or have this direct link. So give me kind of a scale of like how much latency we were talking about before and how much we're talking about with this new technology.
So already in 5G and 5G Advanced, we are talking about very low latency. When we are moving to 6G and when we are moving to this optimization with AI, we are talking about an order of magnitude difference, so which is quite impressive. And so meaning that we are able to optimize the latency, so that means that for gamers or gaming, for video streaming, suddenly you will have the real user experience that people have been promising for the past at least 5 years. So we are saying the technology is mature. Now the applications need to be developed to take advantage of this technology. First of all, we need to drive better efficiency so that the operators, when they are deploying that, they are getting a lower cost per bit and so are inclined to deploy this 6G.
And so, yeah. Moving back to the actual showcase that we're seeing right here. So can you tell me a little bit about this ML showcase? And because when we think AMD, we think about processors, we think about GPUs, we think about like cloud computes. What's the ML showcase here?
So first of all, let me just refresh the memory of the people. Is 2.5 years ago, AMD acquired a company called Xilinx, which was the number one market leader into the FPGA. So now AMD is the market leader for the FPGA SoC. So what we are seeing here is the AMD FPGA side of it.
Could you just clarify what's an FPGA?
Yeah, FPGA, it's a chip that you can reprogram, can have different personas. You can have the same device doing automotive, so being in a car, being on an airplane, being on a radio. So this is really the reprogramming this device based on the application that you are addressing.
But I thought that was the point of a CPU. So like what's the
CPU is CPU is running software. FPGA are much closer to the as an hardware, as an ASIC base, and can be much more efficient.
So for my audience, what's an ASIC?
So an ASIC, it's a piece of silicon which is made for one purpose only, where FPGAs are done for multi-personas. Same capabilities, same optimization, but then you will have to program the FPGA to the application that you want to drive, radios, AIML, automotive, aerospace and defense, so those type of things.
Yeah, and when most people learned about ASICs, that was during the crypto boom.
Yep.
Like when you have a crypto miner that's 10, 100 or like 200 times more effective than a GPU, that's the advantage of an ASIC, right?
Yep.
Like it's so much more efficient.
By the way, let me interrupt you here. Probably more than 60% of the crypto mining is done with FPGAs.
Yeah.
Because the latency, we talk about the latency, which is very important, and the parallel processing that the FPGAs can do.
But one of the issues with FPGAs as well is the amount of throughput that there is, right? Like I remember the Antminers when we were at Series 8, Series 9, people couldn't get their hands on it. So for a player like AMD that has the scale, are able to meet that demand.
Yes.
Then like the advantages are obvious.
Yep. Again, we are talking about devices that are multiple terabits, that are 50 teraflops of capabilities for compute. So So we are really thinking about applications that before were not possible. So we are really in a new world of AIML. And by the way, one size does not fit all. So those FPGAs for the AIML will fit well on the edge.
Okay.
Where on the cloud, you will need GPUs to do that, or CPUs to do that.
And because I think, yeah, this demonstration of 6G,
yep,
or like ML is directly embedded and is necessary to get that latency,
yep,
down.
Yep.
That's a really good application. Can you give me some other ones in terms of like where this AI directly embedded into processors or directly embedded into the devices that we use?
For example, power management. Power management, security are another one where you can predict.
Like what kind of security? Because when you say security, you think
security,
like, oh,
could
security
be DDoS.
Okay.
So DDoS, like, so preventing the
data centers.
Yeah. Exactly, preventing the attack. You can predict by looking at the patterns with AIML and training them, and after that doing the inference in the FPGA to make sure that you are protecting your system before being hacked.
Mm.
So where you will be able to detect the first type of patterns that will prove that you will be attacked and then being able to protect yourself. So those are other things. High-speed trading will be another one where the latency will be very important and where AIML will be able also to help by predicting patterns of the market evolution.
So that's all kind of enterprise level features. For people who are watching my show, like, what's an actual visible products that has an impact.
You have heard about the AI PCs,
yeah,
that AMD is talking a lot about it. We announced recently that we're working with Microsoft on their Copilot, which means that from an end user perspective, you will be able to have new applications around the user experience in your PC for gaming, for rendering, for managing your PC. You will be able to speak to your PC saying, you know what, I'm looking for the two slides I presented 3 years ago in this meeting for this subject. Boom, AI will be able to come up with and find for you those slides instead of you spending hours looking for the slides. So there are a lot of new things coming into the end user. Gaming, of course, is another one. And we will talk about the gaming if you want later on. But that's also, gaming will be a big user of this AI in the edge.
So we're now at the Wall of Love. Can you tell me what makes it the Wall of Love and why we're talking about
WC? So in fact, here what we have is our ecosystem and our customers demonstrating and showcasing their platforms with our technology inside. So what you have in the back are servers, big servers with our latest generation of CPUs from AMD. And what you have here on my left, this is the radios made in China with the AMD technology inside, and that every of those vendors are using our leading edge technology to be able to deliver the right product. SoCs from AMD, classic Xilinx,
okay,
technology.
And so, yeah, what's it being leveraged for? Is it the signal processing from the antennas?
Yeah, so they are leveraging several things. They are leveraging the lo-fi, so the baseband on the radio.
What is that?
The baseband. Which is doing all the signal processing intelligence.
Okay.
It's done in the radio. All the spectrum and what we call RF, radio frequency, is also done on the same device. So all those things can be done in a single device and to improve the integration and reduce the power of those radios.
Where previously that was lots of individual components,
exactly,
that would take more power, but would take more, like,
more space
for the integrator.
Exactly.
Yep. I see. Okay, so yeah, you wanted to talk to me about these devices we have behind us. Can you tell me a little bit about
it? Yeah, so here, in fact, this is a company called Areacom, which is an end-to-end customer and partner of us.
Okay.
They are doing from the radio to the server, all with AMD technology inside, and they are then helping their own customers, like operators, private enterprise, to deploy their systems end-to-end for the 5G, by the way. This is for 5G. From the 5G core, which is doing all the call processing, up to the base station and the gateway, which is connecting all the radios and the radios. So all using AMD inside. So this is the point I want to make here, is AMD has a large ecosystem that we are playing with. And so Areacom in China is one of the best partners we have.
Yeah, that kind of helps us understand, like, how much work it is to get these networks in place, because a lot of people might think like, oh yeah, you just plug in the fiber optics, you plug in the other side.
Yeah, it's almost as simple as that, just a little bit more complex.
Yeah, you have a little bit more things. I think we can close off our interview on this.
Yep.
Thank you so much for taking the time to
talk. Alfred, thank you very much.
Fascinating, and I think our viewers will have learned a lot as well.
Thank you very much.